All right, now what?
How old is you?
Me.
No. No, it's not how old she is, it's what age she was when she became a Christian. But if you get it right, what year, you get a five. No, 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 you can't, you don't get that.
Well, I have that book.
You get one.
I've got that book.
Come on, have a guess. Well, she's about 25. What would you go for? Zero. When you were Alaska, hang on, Alaska. Is that correct?
It's wrong, sorry.
Sorry, good try. Anybody else? All you've got to do is tell me what year, what age was this young lady when she became a Christian, and you get a fiver. A man said she was born. You can't be. So he lost his fiver.
18.
Anybody else?
18.
You're a naughty man. You're a naughty man.
I was going to get
that
a fiver
man,
on
that
me.
That man there just said,
I was going to get a fiver then.
Now look, so this is Warren and this is Emma. Okay, Emma, you're from Wigan?
I am, yes.
Tell us what you do for a living.
So I do two things. So I run a theatre school, and at the minute I'm teaching in a primary school as well.
Okay, so you work, you
I
pay your
work,
taxes, and you're happily married.
I'm married.
Okay. Right. Now, this is what I want to know, Emma, is what age were you when you became a real Christian?
I was 18, very nearly 19.
And how many years ago was that?
Five years ago.
I told you about 25. Okay. Now look, Emma and Warren, just give me one reason why you believe there is a God. Because a lot of people will say, I don't think there is a God. So I want you to give me one reason why you believe there is a God, Emma, and one reason, Warren. So the question is, why do you believe there's a God anyway?
I think there's a God because If the world didn't just begin, I think it's like you have two rocks, right? If you hit two rocks together, that's only going to create destruction. It never ever creates life. It always creates destruction.
Okay.
So that's the way I see it. I'm doing sport exercise science. I do science as well.
Yeah.
So
you're saying, Warren, when you look at the world, it's so fantastic you can't believe it could make itself.
Yeah.
Alright, that's what. Ladies and gentlemen, if you've just joined us, I love the people who have no faith in God to join me. You can't give me any hope whatsoever. You don't know where we've come from, you're all guessing, and I've got the answers, and that's why I'm here. Now look, you said you believe there's a God because of the wonder of the universe. Emma, you believe in God.
Yeah.
Tell us why you believe there's a God.
Because without God, it leaves the biggest questions in life unanswered.
Like what?
Like, what's our purpose? What's our meaning?
Hang on. So, if there's no God, you're saying we don't really have a purpose?
Yeah.
So we find ourselves all on planet Earth, 8 billion of us, and we don't really know why we're here.
Absolutely, yeah.
But what do you think people would say the reason is that we're here? If there's no God, what do you think they say? Well, I'm here because?
Because of chance, evolution, you're here.
But hang on a minute, are you saying, Emma, that I'm just on the same level as a cat?
No.
Because if you think about it for a minute, okay. If I've nobody to start me off,
yeah.
And I'm just here, and I am to look in the mirror one day and say, oh, I'm a beautiful looking young man, but I've got a cat, and there's no reason why the cat should be here, aren't we on equal pegging? If you think about it. So I say to you, next door is your neighbour who's drowning in a swimming pool and your dog's next to him. Do you save the dog or the next door neighbour? What do you say? What's wrong with you, sir? You're a rude man. Well, you don't have to be rude, sir. You don't have to be rude. No, sir, you don't have to be rude. Rude man, wasn't he? Rude man over there. Now, ladies and gentlemen, so my question is this. Emma, I'd be on the same level as a cat.
Yeah.
I mean, why is a cat more precious than me? Why am I more precious than a cat? Think about it. Well, that was saying.
Yeah.
Tell us, Emma, just tell us what happened to you very quickly the day you became a Christian.
Yeah.
I realised that without God, no ultimate hope, also, your purpose and meaning in life. I'm a human being, I'm a sinner, but I knew the only way to be right with God is
Okay, now my question is this. Why do so many people drink if they're satisfied? That's a good question, isn't it? Why do so many people drink if they're satisfied? It's a great question. But drink takes you out yourself. If you're satisfied with your life, ladies and gentlemen, tell me why do so many people in our society get drunk? Why? Because they're not satisfied. They want something more, they want a kick. And the problem is, we run out of kicks eventually. And I'll tell you something, if you get life eternal, that Emma's got, that Warren's got, you get heaven. It's free. And it's to anybody who'll stop and listen. I'm going to let you down there. Thanks, Warren. Just stay here, eh? Now look. Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to do my little talk, and I want any atheist who can think can give me the answer. You ready? And here it is. They made a robot called Rex. This is how they made it. Remember the bits of Rex? The master universe he was made in. So his tracking was made in London, trinkets were made in California. Now, if you're an atheist, you're going to be stuck, because I'm going to say in a minute, over to you, and we're all listening. See, and you've got to come up with the answer. So think about it. Rex is the robot. All these bits are made in those universities, and it comes out in this newspaper called The Daily Mail. Okay, you get it? Now, here's the next thing. I'm going to show you a picture of another robot. Tell me which of the two robots is the most advanced. Get it? Rex, everybody made it in these universities, showed up in the Daily Mail. Okay? Here's my question. Which of these two robots is the most advanced? This one or this one? Which is the most advanced? Give me one machine in your house that can mend itself. Just one. Computer? Your car? Your iron? Your TV, your DVD set, one machine in your house that can mend itself. Just one. Have you got one? No? That one can mend itself. Ladies and gentlemen, that tells me that I needed all these minds to make Rex